We're on the air.
Hi, this is Keith Raffel in my home office. Instead of typing out a blog this week, I'm trying having it videoed by my expert videographer, number four, my 11-year-old son. Speaking of my 11-year-old son, last week we went to an open house at his middle school to be on El Camino in Palo Alto, California. Well, in truth, it's in Palo Alto now, but 70 years ago, in 1940, it was in Barron Park, which was not in Palo Alto. What's the significance of that? Well, when Stanford University was founded, which of course is in Palo Alto, Governor Stanford had the California State Legislature pass a law that said that no liquor could be sold or served within a mile and a half of the campus. Right where Harry's school is a mile and a half beyond that limit. Of course, that law is long gone. But the historical novel, the historical thriller I'm working on now, is set in the Stanford and Palo Alto of 1940. It was an exciting year. Stanford had its best football team ever. They went undefeated and won the Rose Bowl. John Kennedy, the ambassador to England's son, was a special student at Stanford. And he and lots of other Stanford fraternity types, sorority types, and athletes used to hang around at the bars and restaurants in Barron Park across from where Harry's school is now, especially at a place called L'Omelette's. At L'Omelette's, you could get a drink, a martini, or something called a Tom and Jerry, for a quarter. And a whole carafe of table wine was only 75 cents. Those were the days. John Kennedy would be JFK, would be holding court there at Lommy's on a stool by the bar. So when I walked out of the open house at Harry School last week, I've been spending so much time in 1940 Palo Alto and in this L'Omelette's, drinking in my mind only, all of a sudden I felt like I was almost there. I felt a tug back 70 years to 1940. Now, when I write, I do sort of love to be in this alternative universe, but I never felt it so strongly in an actual place before. Now, E.L. Doctorow, the famous novelist, said, writing fiction is a socially acceptable form of schizophrenia. But I've never felt the schizophrenia, not at my laptop, but on the street, in the place where the action happened in my work in progress, like I did this time. Very unusual. I'm wondering if something like this has ever happened to any of you, where you were at a place that you wrote about in your novel, and you were drawn back, or you draw into the fictional world that you just created. Well, maybe we'll try video blogging again. Let me know if you like it. Let me know if you've ever been pulled back that way. And thanks to number four, my videographer. As my number three likes to say to me, I'll say to you, I'll be watching you. Thanks very much.
And we're out.